أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل إنما أنا بشر مثلكم يوحى إلي أنما إلهكم إله واحد فمن كان يرجو لقاء ربه فليعمل عملا صالحا ولا يشرك بعبادة ربه أحدا.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين حمدا بجميع المحامد على جميع النعم حمدا لا يتناهى ملء السماوات وملء الأرض وملء ما بينهما وملء ما شاء الله من شيء بعد كما تحب يا ربي وترضى ولك العتبى حتى ترضى ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. اللهم صل على محمد في الأولين وصل على محمد في الآخرين وصل على محمد في كل وقت وحين وصل على محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. الله عز وجل سيد نزور من سورة الذاريات. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون. الله said I create jinn and human being only to worship me. And this worship to Allah, as I already told you in many times, must be sincerely for the sake of Allah alone, nothing else. And the last halaqa for me, it was about what is the harm of riya, what is the harm of show off. I said the summary, it will weak your iman, it will make your iman and your faith and your aqeedah weak. Already also it is kind of shirk, as Rasulullah ﷺ classified as a shirk. It is a disease. If you do not deal with it, this show off with your deeds, it will increase and it will make you go astray. Also, it will destroy your amal, because Allah wants you to do any good deeds sincerely for Him only. For that, if you do it for show off, is not for Allah, and Allah does not accept from you except whatever completely sincerely to Him. Already says the hadith of hadith al-Qudsi, يقول الله إذا جاز الناس بأعمالهم اذهبوا إلى الذين كنتم تراؤون في الدنيا فانظروا هل تجدون عندهم جزاء. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives a reward to the people for their deeds, He will say, go to those people you used to show them off. Will you find any reward with them? Also, Allah will humiliate and disgrace the one who show off with his amal, with his deeds. إذلال الله للمرائي. والفارق بين الرياء والسمعة الرياء لما يرى من العمل كالصلاة والسمعة لما يسمع كالرياء بالقراءة والوعظ والذكر والتحدث بما عمله. من الأضرار أيضا, one of the reasons to enter hellfire, and the first people will be hellfire heated up with, start with, is the people who show off. Also, one of the harm of riya, that you will never be able to prostrate yourself in front of Allah the day of Qiyamah. And I already explained all of this. One of the harm of riya, you will never find the smell of al-Jannah, as already the hadith and ayat. The reasons of riya, we said, weakness of iman, and it will also make it more weaker if you do not deal with it, if you do not treat it. Love of praising of people to you. If you love it and you want it and you looking for it, the people to praise you, you will show off, and this is not, should not be happened. Fear of criticism and fear of also that the people blame you. this is will make you to show off. When you are greedy and you want whatever in the hand of other people, you will show off. Then we stop with the turuq al-riya, methods of al-riya. I said al-riya'u bil-badani, al-riya'u bil-qawl, al-riya'u bil-malbasi wal-madhari, al-riya'u bil-ashabi, al-riya'u bil-a'ila. I said there is five different kinds. Show off by body, show off by speech, show off by your appearance, show off by your company and by your friends, show off by your family, from which family you are in. Number one, الرياء بالبدن, show off with your body. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إنما الأعمال بالنيات. All of your amal will be rewarded and accepted or even rejected because of your intention, according to your intention. For that if the intention sincerely to Allah, Allah will accept your amal. If your intention not sincerely to Allah for show off and for getting praising of the people, will never be accepted. Al-a'mal, which it is the deeds, either a'mal by body, like al-hajj and the salah. And this is show off with the body, with the things you do it with your body and you show off with it, some actions. Al-riya'u bil-qawl. Al-riya'u bil-qawl, show off with the speech and with the talking. When you advise the others to do good, not for the sake of Allah, but only your intention to advise them in order to let them think about you that you are a pious man and you are a, have a taqwa and you are very good. For that you advise not sincerely for Allah, this is show off by speech. This is as examples. قال ابن رجب حتى الناقد لنفسه أمام الآخرين حتى يظن أنه إنسان جيد أو ممتاز فهذا رياء. If even you criticize your own self in front of others in order to let the other think about you that you are a good man and you are a very excellent, this is also show off. Now we go back to one thing, that it is very important. Do everything sincerely for the sake of Allah and hide it. Hide it because you know and you're sure that Allah knows it, and enough for you that Allah knows it. And you will never get nothing from the people. The only one you will get from is Allah Azza wa Jalla. Also show off with your appearance, show off with your money, show off with your money like sadaqah, you can show off with it. Show off with your appearance like your house, your car, your deeds. This is, should not be. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you talk about the munafiq, the hypocrite, in Surah Al-Munafiqeen, verse number 4, the Munafiqeen itself, Surah number 63. Allah Azza wa Jal said, وَإِذَا رَعَيْتَهُمْ تُعْجِبْكَ أَجْسَامُهُمْ وَإِن يَقُولُوا تَسْمَعْ لِقَوْلِهِمْ كَأَنَّهُمْ خُشُبٌ مُسَنَّدَةٌ يَحْسَبُونَ كُلَّ صَيْحَةٍ عَلَيْهِمْ هُمُ الْعَدُوُّ فَاحْذَرْهُمْ قَاتَلَهُمُ اللَّهُ أَنَّا يُؤْفَكُونَ. Allah Azza wa Jal saying in this ayah, and when you look at them, their body, their appearance pleases you. And when they speak, you listen to their words. They are as a block of wood propped up. They think that every cry is against them. They think that every cry is against them. They are the enemy. So beware of them. Allah said, قاتلهم الله. May Allah curse them. How are they denying or deviating from the right path? Here Allah mentioned that when you see them, when you look at them, their body will, and their appearance will pleases you. For that there is show off with the appearance, show off with your body. With your also money. When you do anything not sincerely for Allah, this is show off. And Allah count and Rasulullah count show off as a part of shirk. Also show off with the company and with the friends, that this rich man is the best friend I have, and this man in the very high position, this is my friend, and this group of people, this is my. And originally, when you befriend with anyone, to be friend to him for show off or for the sake of Allah? For the sake of Allah Azza wa Jalla. الأخلاء بعضهم يومئذ لبعض عدو إلا المتقين. The friends, if it is not for the sake of Allah, they will be enemy to each other. Allah say, إِلَّا الْمُتَّقِينَ. إِلَّا الْمُتَّقِينَ means except the pious, the righteous, the one who have a strong faith. Also, show off with the family. Have a lot of different kind. Like with the kids, my son is so and so, my son is Hafiz. If it is not for the sake of Allah, if you say it and you mean that it is for the sake of Allah, is different. But for show off, as an engineer, as this and that, he's in this big company, all of this show off should not be happening. Because who give it to you? Allah Azza wa Jalla. And you should be thankful and grateful and happy with it, and sincerely to the one who give it to you only, not to show off with it. Also, there is some other things is not counted as show off. Some of the things is not counted as a show off. حمد الناس للعبد على فعل الخير دون قصد منه أو نية. If there is a people by themselves without any intention from you, they praise you for what you do, for what you did, without any intention from you, you are not seeking that. You do sincerely for Allah, but Allah send you to you some people praising what you did. This is not. What is the proof? عن أبي ذر قال قيل يا رسول الله أرأيت الرجل يعمل العمل من الخير ويحمده الناس عليه قال تلك عاجل بشرى المؤمن. They asked يا رسول الله what about if somebody doing something good, but the people by themselves came and praised him for what he did. Rasulullah said this is the hasten of the glad tidings of Allah to him. Allah hastens the glad tidings of Allah to him that you are doing good. Allah making the people to come to him and praise him for what he did, a sign from Allah that Allah is happy. But this is as long as is not from your own. Originally, you do not do the deeds in order to let the people praising you. Also, one of the things is not show off when you advise others sincerely for Allah, because already you are ordered to do that. الدين النصيحة قلنا لمن يا رسول الله قال لله ولرسوله ولأئمة المسلمين وعامتهم. This deen is نصيحة, is advice. They said to who? For the sake of Allah and also for أئمة المسلمين وعامتهم, means for the leaders of the Muslims, sincerely for the sake of Allah and for common people, for everybody. As long as sincerely to Allah and according to Quran and Sunnah, في سبيل الله is acceptable and it is not show off. Also, نشاط العبد في عمل الخير مع العابدين ومصاحبة الصالحين لوجه الله الكريم ليست رياء. If you are active for doing good with a group of people, when you see them, you will pray more. When you sit with them, you will read Quran. They are good people, encouraging you to do good more. And while you are with them, you will be happy to do more. This is not show off also. And Abi Musa al-Ash'ari, Rasulullah himself said, مثل الجليس الصالح والجليس السوء كحامل المسك ونافخ الكير. The example of the good friend and the example of the evil one, bad friend, like the one who have the example of the good one, righteous one, is the example of the one who have perfume with him. And the example of the one bad one is the example of the one who have a charcoal, fire in front of him and bringing a lot of smoke and bad smell. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, فحامل المسك إما أن يحذيك وإما أن تبتاع منه وإما أن تجد منه ريحا طيبة. The example of the good friend, either he will give you a gift of this perfume he have, or you will buy from him, or at least he will smell a good smell from the perfume he have. This is the example of the good people. You will worship Allah more with them. Here Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم praise it and give good example of it, like those people who have perfume. Opposite of that, the bad one is like Nafikh al-Kir, the one who have charcoal and he have blow air in it, bringing smoke. إما أن يحرق ثيابك وإما أن تجد منه ريحا منتنة. Either he will burn your clothes, out of some of the fire come to you, will burn your clothes, if it does not burn you completely. Or the second one, at least you will find the smell of the smoke and bad smell coming out from the charcoal. This is the two examples Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to let you know. This is other hadith. Al-mar'u ala deeni khalilihi falyanzur ahadukum man yukhalil. Everyone will be the way, will be with the way, and will be with the with the way of the one who is friend to. Either he will affect you to do good with him, or if he is bad, he will also lead you to do bad with him. At least the good one, at the time of prayer, he will remind you what? The prayer, come pray. Time of doing good, he will encourage you to do good. But the one is not good. If he is your friend, time of the prayer, and even you want, he will make you lazy. Oh, not now. Wait, no problem. Later. Yeah, let us watch. When we finish this watching of this shaitan, then we will go. Wal'ayaz billah. For that, this is the difference between both of them. What is the way to avoid riya'? What's the treatment? In order to get this ikhlas and this sincerity to Allah and to avoid this show off, number one, you have to increase your knowledge, Islamic knowledge. Increase your iman, increase your knowledge. Ziyadatu al-ilmi. In Surah Fatir, verse number 28, Fatir is a Surah number 35, Allah Azza wa Jal give a very big and very huge certificate.
إنما يخشى الله من عباده العلماء إن الله عزيز غفور.
It is only those who have knowledge, علماء, عالمز, among his slaves that fear Allah. Listen to it carefully. From between the whole creation of Allah, Allah giving certificate that the only one fear me really from between the people is the عالمز. Why? Because of the knowledge they have, Allah give it to them. They know how to worship Allah. As everybody knows, one alim more harder against shaitan than 1,000 abid. Abid means only worship Allah, even 1,000, but without knowledge, one alim is better than all of them. And he will be harder against shaitan than them. Because if you have the knowledge, you will do the right. And it's the only way to go near to Allah is the knowledge. The only way to be sincerely to Allah, to have this kind of knowledge. The only way to avoid show off, you have to learn. Also, one of the things to avoid the show off is the dua. Remember when I said you hadith of Rasulullah, al-dua huwa al-ibadah. Itself is a ibadah, and it is one of the very good ibadah to do, as Rasulullah himself, when he said about the riya, akhfa min dabib al-naml, more hidden than the walking of the ant. Remember this hadith I told you last time? قالوا وكيف نتقي الرياء يا رسول الله وهو أخفى من دبيب النمل. They said, يا رسول الله, how you will avoid show off? And it is more hidden than the ant. فقال قولوا اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من أن نشرك بك شيئا نعلمه ونستغفرك لما لا نعلمه. The dua, you should learn it. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من أن نشرك بك شيئا نعلمه ونستغفرك لما لا نعلمه. The meaning, oh Allah, we seek refuge to you to do shirk while we know, and we ask you to forgive us if we do shirk while we don't know. Because sometimes you will commit it while you don't feel it, because it is very hidden, like the hidden of the small ant at the dark night. One of the treatment also to avoid show off, كتمان العمل ورجاء القبول والخوف من ضياع العمل والإخلاص لله. كتمان العمل, hide your deeds. Remember when I told you, if you have a very big gold piece of gold, what will you do? You will hide it. Your good deeds is more precious than the gold. Your good deeds is more expensive and more precious and more beneficial to you than any gold. For that, as you hide that, you should hide your deeds in order to with the intention. Make it sincerely to Allah. You did something good for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not only that, وَرَجَاءُ الْقَبُولِ Always hope, oh Allah, accept my deeds. Because when you say to the people, you will never get nothing. Not from the people, not from Allah. Everything gone. When you show off for people with your hajj, or your sadaqah, with your deeds, with anything good you did. Firstly, Allah will not accept that, right or wrong? Because you show off to the people. Second, what will you get from people? Believe me, nothing. That means you lost both sides, not Allah, not the people. And also, it could be completely show off to the people also or mixed. Some of the people, they have this problem, two intentions, for Allah and for the people. Also, Allah does not accept that. Allah wanted completely to him. Also fear about your deed that you will be lost. If you fear about your deed that it will be lost, then what will you do? You will try to make it sincerely to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When it is big piece of gold, will you fear about it to lose it or no? You should fear about your good deeds as you fear about this piece of gold. Piece of gold is nothing comparing it to your good deeds with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sincerely to him. Hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, سَبْعَةٌ يُظُلُّهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي ظِلِّهِ Seven kind of people will be shaded by the shade from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, under the shade of Allah. يَوْمَ لَا ظِلَّ إِلَّا ظِلُّ When there is no any shade except from him alone. One of them, رَجُلٌ تَصَدَّقَ بِصَدَقَةٍ فَأَخْفَاهَا حَتَّى لَا تَعْلَمَ شِمَالُهُ مَا تُنْفِقْ يَمِينَ A man spend a sadaqah so sincerely to Allah and so secretly. So secretly, a man spends with his right hand, sadaqah for the sake of Allah, so secretly, until his left hand doesn't know what his right hand spends for the sake of Allah. Look how so much he was sincerely. This kind of people will be shaded by the shade of Allah. This is the one who will be deserve that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, okay, because you did it for me. When you did it for people, will any man who will have umbrella to you at the day of judgment, when the sun will be over your head like this? Impossible. Allah deserves from you to worship Him alone and to be sincerely to Him. Also, one of the things to avoid this riya, مصاحبة أهل الإخلاص والتقوى والبعد عن المرائين والمنافقين. To be always with the people of sincerity, to be always with the people of taqwa, to be always with the people of fear of Allah. When you be a friend to those people, they will lead you to. But when you are with the people of munafiqeen, hypocrite, mura'een, show off, shayateen, where they will lead you? People of al-Jannah will lead you to? And people of al-Nar wal-A'azu billah will lead you to? For that, choose which one you want. And there is no in between. You must be one of those, either with this or that. Allah said, do not be with those al-mura'een and al-munafiqeen. Very clear. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say what?
ولا تركنوا إلى الذين ظلموا فتمسكم النار.
Do not even recline to. Allah does not say helping or cooperating and befriend to. No. Allah said do not even be reclining to, even with your own heart, to those zalim. Because the fire will touch you. Means you will be punished. Also, one of the very good things to avoid riya. And to avoid this disease, معرفة الرياء وأسبابه ودوافعه وخطورته. When you know what is the riya, what is the reasons of it, what is that, how to avoid it, how it is very dangerous. Do you remember when I told you that it is more dangerous against you than المسيح الدجال himself? Look how dangerous is it. If you know that, and if you avoid the reasons of it, like what I told you, when you know that it will make your iman weak, then make your iman strong to avoid it. Make your relation between you and Allah strong in order to avoid. Make your amal sincerely to Him. And do not think that this will come to you in 1 second. It will. You will struggle with it all of your life till the last minute. Because anything related to the intention, as the ulama is saying, is a very hard and it needs continuously from you sincerity to Him.
Also, when I said to you, one of the reasons of it to avoid it, when you love from the people to praise you, and you are doing for them to show off them to praise you for what you did, that you are intelligent and you are rich and you are doing this and you did that. يا أخي احتسب عملك لله وأخلص له. Make your عمل sincerely to Allah alone. والاحتساب في الإسلام انتظار الجزاء من الله فقط. Means to await the reward from Allah alone. Deal with Allah. Think about Him سبحانه وتعالى. Do not think about anything else. Nobody will benefit you. The only one can benefit you is Allah. The only one can remove the harm you have is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, one of the description I already told you about, that Allah described Ibad al-Rahman and described the good people, that لا يخافون في الله لهم تلائم. They don't fear the blame of any blamers about the good they do. Because they do it sincerely for Allah, they forget about the good world. Do not be greedy about the positions and about the what the others have. Be thankful to Allah, you will not show off to those people. Also, correct your intention continuously. Correct your intention. Because you are created to worship Allah alone. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send any messenger, the first thing the messenger say to them, قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهِ. Give you some example. In Surah Al-A'raf, verse number 59. لَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا نُوحًا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ فَقَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرُهُ. Allah said, we send Nuh to his people. The first thing he said to them, فَقَالَ يَا قَوْمِ, O my people, worship Allah alone, you do not have any ilah except him. Make your amal sincerely to him. In verse number 65 in Surah Al-A'raf, وإلى عاد أخاهم هودا قال يا قوم اعبدوا الله. To add their brother Hood, the first thing, say, yeah, my people, worship Allah alone. وإلى ثمود أخاهم صالحا قال يا قوم اعبدوا الله. To ثمود, their brother صالح, he said, oh my people, worship Allah alone. وإلى مدين أخاهم شعيبا قال يا قوم اعبدوا الله. To مدين, their brother شعيب, he said, oh my people, worship Allah alone. In Surah Al-Zukhruf, verse number 64. إن الله هو ربي وربكم فاعبدوه. Allah is my Lord and your Lord, worship him alone. In Surah Al-Anbiya, verse number 25. وما أرسلنا من قبلك من رسول إلا نوحي إليه أنه لا إله إلا أنا فاعبدون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about all messengers. Saying to Rasulullah, we never send any messenger before you, except we revealed to him that there is no God except Allah alone. Worship him alone. To learn that, this is the session, this is the halaqa. To learn this. If you try to achieve that and you success to do it, you get a lot. If you didn't get anything except only this one, to be sincerely to Allah, and to avoid show off, alhamdulillah, you get a lot. Here, oh my people, worship Allah alone. Oh my people, worship Allah alone. Anyone go against that, one of five. Anyone go against that, one of five. Listen to it. طاغوت ينازع الله في ربوبيته وألوهيته. Tyrant. He fight Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his rububiyyah and his uluhiyyah, and I already explained with all details what is the rububiyyah and what is the uluhiyyah. Means he calling the people to worship him. Example of that, huh? Fir'aun, excellent. And Namrud. Namrud, Allah mentioned about him that he was calling the people to worship him. Also, whoever does not judge by the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he worship his own mind, and he want to the people to do according to his own way, not the way of Allah, this is the same kind. Wal'ayazu billah. Number two, another kind of taghut, لا يدعو الناس إلى عبادته بل يدعوهم لعبادة الأوثان. He does not call the people to worship him, but he calls them to worship other than Allah. Idols or whatever it is. Again, this title related to the show off, related to the shirk, because the umbrella of the topic of all of it, we're still about shirk and the different kind of it. I said Allah send all messengers to the all people saying worship Allah alone, right? Anyone does not do that, he will be one of these. Tyrant, he is calling the people to worship him, or tyrant, he is calling the people to worship others than Allah. Or, wal'ayyazu billah, mushrik. He will ask and do dua for others than Allah. He will go and make sacrifice the animals or make some of the ibadah to others than Allah. He will make most of his ibadah or some of it. Most of his ibadat, most of his action of worship, either to others, most of it or some of it, mixed. This is mushrik. Also, whoever goes against this la ilaha illallah, somebody he doubted Tawheed. He doubt, he doesn't know it, he doubt. Oh, is it right or wrong? Is it, we could do both, what's the problem? This is, he will doubt. He have doubt about it, he does not know and he have doubt about it. That means either he will make, associate with Allah in the sum of the worship or all of it. Like what? This is related to our topic about show off. You are sincerely in your tawheed to Allah, you will make your deeds sincerely to him only and you will hide it. But if it is not, this is a problem now. Or number five, the jahil. Jahil, he doesn't know. He thinks that shirk will make him near to Allah. ما نعبدهم إلا ليقربونا إلى الله زلفا. We are worshiping them only to make us near to Allah through them. يا أخي, you will never be near to Allah through anybody. You have to be near to Allah as Allah is nearer to you than the blood in your body. ونحن أقرب إليه من حبل الوريد. Allah عز وجل say you are nearer to you than the blood in your body. سبحانه وتعالى. Whatever in your mind, whatever you want to do, whatever intention. Subhanallah, ya akhi, if some of your action without talking, the people will know which person you are. Do you think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not know? Allah before created you, he knows you. For that deal with him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this kind of jahil, majority of the common people which have no knowledge because of jahil, because they do not study and they don't want even to study. And this is a problem. In order to know one halaqa like that is a very, very appreciated by Allah himself. Angels surrounded us and a lot of ahadith talking about the superiority of sitting and learning this knowledge. Because by this knowledge you will be near to Allah, not nothing else. Even it is little, even it is one subject. But it is very important to learn it. It may be Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you tawfiq to act upon one of it. It will be the reason for you to be safe. And alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. There is hadith Qudsi narrated by Imam Muslim. Hadith in the book of Zuhd, number 2985. Narrated also by Ibn Majah in hadith Abu Hurairah. Qala Allahu azza wa jalla. Qala Allah in the hadith Qudsi. Ana aghna ash-shuraka an ash-shirk. I am the most wretched one from anyone who do any shirk. Means what? You will not accept anything contain shirk. من عمل عملا أشرك معي فيه غيري تركته وشركه. Whoever did any deeds associate with me, with Allah. Anyone else, I will leave him and the shirk he have and the عمل he did. And the deeds he did. In Ibn Majah, فأنا بريء وهو الذي أشرك. In Ibn Majah, Allah say, I'm innocent from it. I'm not accepted. And he will go to the one you do shirk to him. For that, when you do any deeds, is not sincerely to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ibn Rajab in Jami' al-Ulum wal-Hikam, in the explanation of innama al-a'malu bin-niyyat, he said, you have to know that the deeds not sincerely to Allah have two kind. Number one, taratan yakunu al-amalu riya'an mahda. Number two, وَتَارَةً يَكُونُ الْعَمَلُ لِلَّهِ وَيُشَارِكُهُ الرِّيَاءُ. Either the amal, all of it, show off, or mix it. Some of it to Allah and some of it to the people, to other people. If it is completely show off, Allah talk about it, about the munafiqeen. Surah An-Nisa, verse number 142. وَإِذَا قَامُوا إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ قَامُوا كُسَالًا يراعون الناس ولا يذكرون الله إلا قليلا. when they stand even for the prayer, they stand lazy, they don't want to come. They come lazy. Lazy and يراغون الناس. They show off the people. Here show off completely. وَلَا يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. They do not mention the name of Allah except little. Like in Sadaqah, in Hajj, and in this one, his amal already gone, is voided, is wrong, is invalid. The one he did for Allah and for others. Already I told you the hadith many times when a man came and saying, I'm going fi sabilillah, but also for the people to praise me. What is my reward? Huh? Who remember? Rasulullah said, la shay'a lak. Nothing you will have. Inna Allah yuhibbu min al-amali ma kana khalis Allah. Allah love from you to do the deeds completely and sincerely to him only. Hadith Shaddad ibn Auf also, because this man he have two intention. Or his intention divided, some for Allah, some for the people. Rasul Hadith of Shaddad ibn Aws, Rawah Imam Ahmad, Man salla yura'i faqad ashrak. Whoever doing the prayer with riyah, it is shirk. Wa man sama yura'i faqad ashrak. Whoever doing sawm with show off, it is shirk. Wa man tasaddaqa yura'i faqad ashrak. Whoever doing sadaqa with riyah, it is a shirk. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ يَقُولُ أَنَا خَيْرُ قَسِيمٍ لِمَنْ أَشْرَكَ بِي فَمَنْ أَشْرَكَ بِي شَيْئًا فَإِنَّ جِدَّةَ عَمَلِهِ قَلِيلُهُ وَكَثِيرُهُ لِشَرِيكُهُ الَّذِي أَشْرَكَ بِهِ أَنَا عَنْهُ غَنِيٌّ. Allah Azza wa Jal say that I am the best, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I will never accept anything have shirk, and whoever have any kind of shirk in his deeds, little or more, I will say to him, go to the one you do shirk for and get for the reward from him. These ahadith and these ayat and this talking about the sincerity for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal, and also talking to you about what it is and what the harm of it, it should make you completely do your amal and struggle before you start in amal and during doing it and after you finish it to keep it sincerely for the sake of Allah. Part also of shirk and part also of explanation of Tawheed will move now to another subject, which it is the next time inshallah, which it is al-khawf. What is al-khawf? What is fear? Alamun yahduthu fil qalbi min khashyati aw tawaqqu'i makruhin sawa'un kana mutayaqqanan aw madhmunan. Fear, everybody of us sometimes he feel fear. What is the fear? What is this fear? What is this khawf? It is some kind of pain happening to your heart. From fear of something hateful or something you dislike will maybe will happen or maybe not. That means either you are sure about it that it will happen to you or sometimes you are not sure. For that this is definition of fear. But the general fear which should be from you to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala completely and perfect must be for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to make it sincerely for the sake of Allah. In Surah Al-Nahl, Allah when he talk about the believers, يَخَافُونَ رَبَّهُمْ مِنْ فَوْقِهِمْ وَيَفْعَلُونَ مَا يُؤْمَرُونَ. They fear their Lord above them and they do what they are commanded to do. Here Allah say, يَخَافُونَ. They fear their Lord only. When he talk about the Anbiya, messengers, what Allah said? وَهُمْ مِنْ خَشْيَتِهِ مُشْفِقُونَ. And they stand in awe for fear of him. They fear Allah alone. When he talk about the human being and jinn, Allah said, وَلِمَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ جَنَّتًا. But for him who fears the standing before his Lord, there will be two Jannah to him. When Allah talk about himself, he said, فَإِيَّايَ فَارْهَبُونَ. Fear me alone. Fear me alone. Don't fear anybody except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Surah Al-Ma'idah, Allah talk about himself also. فَلَا تَخْشَوُ النَّاسَ وَخْشَوُونَ. Do not fear the people and fear me only. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talk about the shaytan, that he will make his follower fear. Have fear in Al-Imran, verse number 137 173 to 175.
الذين قال لهم الناس إن الناس قد جمعوا لكم فاخشوهم فزادهم إيمانا وقالوا حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل.
This is a very strong one from Allah himself in his book.
حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل.
Repeat it as much as you can. Because Allah ordered you in the Quran.
When you say حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل,
Allah said فانقلبوا بنعمة من الله وفضل لم يمسسهم سوء واتبعوا رضوان الله والله ذو فضل عظيم. Five things you get, just you repeat حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. Allah said in this ayah in Surah Al Imran, الذين قال لهم الناس إن الناس قد جمعوا لكم فاخشوهم. Those people who the other came to them and say, oh, the other people gathered themselves against you, fear them. فخشوهم, fear them. We're talking about fear now. Fear must be from Allah alone, not from anybody. Don't fear except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is increase their iman, and they say, حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. Allah is sufficient for us. حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. Rasulullah said it. حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. Sayyidina Ibrahim, when they throw him to the fire, what he said? حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. Jibril came to him. ألك حاجة يا إبراهيم? Do you need, while he was going to the fire, do you need anything, Ibrahim? He said, حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. When you say it and repeat it as much as you can, Allah say, فانقلبوا بنعمة من الله. You will get grace, نعمة, a lot of favor from Allah to you. وفضل, superiority from Allah, degrees. لم يمسسهم سوء. They will never be touched by any harm. واتبعوا رضوان الله. And they follow the pleasure of Allah. والله ذو فضل عظيم. Five things. والله ذو فضل عظيم, and Allah has a great bounty upon you. طيب, if they do not, Allah say the next,
إنما ذلكم الشيطان يخوف أولياءه فلا تخافوهم وخافون إن كنتم مؤمنين.
This is the shaitan will make his follower to fear. Allah say, do not fear. Do not fear them, do not fear anybody. Fear Allah alone if you are a believer. Going with more with this topic about the fear and about how many kind of fear, which one of it is a shirk and which one of it is not counted as a shirk, inshallah the next halaqa will be about it. Then we ask Allah by His great name to give us al-ikhlas to Him and to make us avoid the riya'. اللهم إنا نسألك حبك وحب من يحبك وحب كل عمل يقربنا إلى حبك يا رب العالمين وجعلنا أشد حبا لك يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارزقنا الإخلاص في القول والعمل. اللهم ارزقنا الإخلاص في القول والعمل. اللهم من أرادنا بسوء فاجعل نحره في عنقه واجعل تدبيرهم تدميرهم وسلط عليهم من لا يخافك ولا يرحمهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعلنا وأهالينا في ضمانك وأمانك وإحسانك وحفظك ورعايتك ونصرك وتأييدك يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعلنا وأهالينا في ضمانك وأمانك وإحسانك وحفظك ورعايتك ونصرك وتأييدك يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك أن نشرك بك شيئا نعلمه ونستغفرك لما لا نعلمه. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك أن نشرك بك شيئا نعلمه ونستغفرك لما لا نعلمه. اللهم ارزقنا حبك وحب من ينفعنا حبه عندك. اللهم ما رزقتنا مما نحب فاجعله قوة لنا فيما تحب. اللهم ما زويت عنا مما نحب فاجعله فراغا لنا فيما تحب. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من العجز والكسل, ونعوذ بك من البخل والجبن, ونعوذ بك من غلبة الدين وقهر الرجال. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك أن نقول زورا أو نغشى فجورا أو نكون بك مغرورين. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من البخل والهرم والقسوة والغفلة والعيلة والذلة والمسكنة, ونعوذ بك من الفقر والكفر والفسوق والشقاق والنفاق والسمعة والرياء.
اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من السمعة والرياء ونعوذ بك من الصمم والبكم والجنون والجذام والبرص وسيء الأسقام يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من يوم السوء ومن ليلة السوء ومن ساعة السوء ومن صاحب السوء ومن جار السوء في دار المقامة يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم كل خير سألك منه نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، ونعوذ بك من كل شر استعاذك منه نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم انصرنا ولا تنصر علينا، وأعنا ولا تعن علينا، وانصرنا على من بغى علينا، واهدنا ويسر الهدى إلينا. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من كل مكروه وسوء يا رب العالمين. اللهم من مكر بنا فامكر به واجعل مكرهم يحيق بهم ويدمرهم تدميرا يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم يا حي يا قيوم، اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى، وارزقنا صدقة جارية وعلما ينتفع به وذرية صالحة تدعو لنا يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى، اللهم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى. اللهم طهر قلوبنا من الغل والحقد والحسد يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم إنا نسألك كل خير سألك منه نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، ونعوذ بك اللهم من كل شر استعاذك منه نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. وجزاكم الله خيرا وبارك الله فيكم، and ask Allah by His great name to accept from all of us and to make us sincerely to Him يا رب العالمين، and to make us avoid the ria and the show off. وجزاكم الله خيرا.